blue sky, just a blacktop road till it's Friday night. At top down, ridge top on, dust trail following all the way home. A cool breeze, head out on the highway. It's time to get a little sideways. Oh yeah, that's right, gonna raise a little hell in the bar tonight, yeah.
Our sheep are going mental.
Hello people, and welcome to another video. Me and Emily are doing Emily's first several day hiking trip. Here she is, doing a thing. We're doing the Ullswater Way. Emily found the whole route, which I'm quite proud of for. Want to say anything? Ullswater is over that way. Ullswater is in the Lake District for anyone who doesn't know. So we've planned a 3 day,
20 miles,
3 days hike. First thing I'll say is I apologise for the wind due to the fact I forgot my wind block. So there will be parts of the video that are slightly muffled, but I'll do my best to try and avoid that. But we're currently heading around the north side of the lake. Yeah, there are some waterfalls on the agenda.
So lunches for this trip consist of salami, sticks, cheese, strings, and whatever sachet sauces I had left over in my kit store. Oh, and these, Emily got these garlic wraps, which are fantastic. I've never had garlic wraps before. And Emily's gone for the set selection of what?
Sandwich thins, five thin ham, a plastic cheese slice, and some salad cream.
Salad cream. And this is our view for lunch on
absolutely beautiful
day one. Winner, winner.
Yeah, that when we get there, we've got another good.
Your snack plan? Emily's got a snack plan.
Gets you through.
Forgot one thing, and one thing only. The goddamn tripod for the camera. So you're not even gonna get those classic floor shots on this trip.
Gonna get wind.
It's gonna be all this oh no, I forgot two things, the muffled thing for the wind and the tripod. So all you're gonna get is these dodgy handheld shots. Sorry about that. Trying to find a sit spot where we can have a flapjack. It's flapjack time! We found a spot.
Ain't nothing better than a hot summer night. Beers in the cooler, come on everyone away. I'm gonna have a good night.
Okay, so we're just we've stopped off for a quick coffee break, and how many kilometers do you reckon we've done?
Ooh.
I reckon we're touching 8 kilometers now, somewhere around there. We've got a couple more to go, roughly about 3 more before we get to where camp is due to be, and it's currently 5:25. Sun doesn't set until about 10 o'clock ish, we've got plenty of time. So we've got the Caldera cone on at the minute.
with my Tokes 850 pot on the go. It's got a brew on quite nicely at the minute. That'll be boiling any time. And we are attempting to get to Acier Falls, which is a waterfall. It should theoretically be just there over that bridge and around the corner. We hope. Emily's and mine, my favourite snack, is caramel waffles. They go very well with Le Coffee. You can, I've also seen these in the shops with covered in chocolate, but we haven't managed to get our hands on any of those yet. Because these are pretty expensive as they are, aren't they?
I'm stabbing around with my crackers.
Okay, so it's currently roughly about 6:45 in the evening. We're a little bit behind schedule, but nothing too major. We're just going to cut today's hike just a little bit shorter. Just the nature of what it is, really. We didn't get to see the waterfalls, which we're a little bit upset about, because we really wanted to see them, but we're just kind of getting a bit tight on time, so we didn't have time to go up the valley to go actually look at them. So that's a bit of a downer, but not the end of the world. We know where they are, so we can always come and see them again. And there's a car park right next to them, so it's not the end of the world. But still running alongside the lake here on the path. Emily's got the walking poles, trying them out. Just trying out the mentality of walking with two poles and trying to doing a full body workout instead of it all being on your legs, which seems to be working. I'm kind of liking it. Oh no.
A bonfire, a big pickin' truck pulled up, a big kickin' country on the radio, songs about the rodeo, sitting on a tailgate, licking on a banjo, beers in the cooler, come on, everyone.
Okay, so we've chosen a campsite for the night. It's that flat area behind us, and we have this kind of, pretty easy to stand up and show you. This kind of concrete thing, whatever it is, but it's making a perfect sitting and table space for cooking up tea. And check out the view. I really like the look of that little island over there. I bet canoes go onto that, maybe have a little camp or something. And there was a wakeboarder just going past somewhere as well. So yeah, we've got a really nice spot set up over there on that flat spot. And we're laughing. Right, we've got some water on the boil, and for tonight's dinner I am having homemade dehydrated Mexican pork and rice. That's in there. Emily's got chicken curry. She didn't trust my food, so she brought her own.
I've had that before and I didn't like it.
Yeah. Pork. Didn't like that one. And then pork doesn't dehydrate that well, so I think it's a bit funny, but whatever. And then I've made this this bag that we can both put our food in and leave it in there to rehydrate. It'll keep it all nice and warm in there. I'm quite proud of that, even though it's a really simple thing. Well, we haven't used it yet, so let's see if it works first before I start bragging about it. Okay, our food is in there. It seems to be working quite nicely. Gonna leave that to sit now for a few minutes and we'll see how we get on. Here's my food. Here's Emily's food. Let the viewers vote which one looks better. Oh, it's fogging up.
I can't taste it though.
Emily, how was your first dehydrated meal?
It was really good. It was more chicken savoury rice than chicken curry, but it was good.
They always are, to be fair.
And then I had crazy hiccups after dinner.
Emily's got the worst hiccups. Like, I totally forgot about it last time she had them, and she just had like them again. And it blew my mind. It's kind of...
Hello.
It's a little bit scary. Check out this beautiful view. The sun is setting now. I apologise for the wind. It's hot chocolate time, I think.
Yeah, Pop-Tarts.
Yeah, Pop-Tarts. For once, the clouds look better on the camera than they do in real life. Look at that. That's trippy. Okay, so there's our shelter for the night. We're currently in slow-mo mode because it's getting pretty dark, so bear with it, but we should be pretty toasty in there. Configured it so the wind's coming from the water's edge and it's going to blow over us. Nighttime report. You can't see us because it's too dark, but we've had to take up our abode inside the shelter because we were getting bitten to shit by midges like crazy for about an hour and we couldn't take it anymore, so we're now hiding in the shelter, which seems to have worked. So hoping for a good night's sleep, and we'll catch you in the morning for day two. Focus on the little moments.
Is the rain coming?
No, it's just the water falling off the trees. Good morning, folks. Welcome to day two of the Lake District Ullswater trip with me and Emily. After getting bitten alive last night by midges, didn't have the best evening. Could have been better. And it's kind of been raining on and off for the night, but we've had a comfortable night. Today it's forecast rain pretty much all day, so we're a little bit worried. Is probably the best word to use. Because we want it to be a pleasurable trip, and today is not looking the best, but we've got some contingencies. The main thing is I don't want Emily to have a bad first several day trip. So we're gonna see how it goes, one step at a time. But at the minute it's looking quite nice, and we're getting breakfast on. So, water is currently got a nice little rolling ball on there on some of the light water. And in here, we've got the porridges prepped. So we've got raspberry and blueberry and apple and cinnamon. Which one do you want?
Apple and cinnamon, please.
Apple and cinnamon. That's good, because I want the raspberry and blueberry. Winner, winner. Okay, camp is broken down while getting attacked to shit by midges. So that was fun. But that's where we had our tent. There are several forest guys which aren't us, but didn't have the resources and the time to go and tidy those up. Nevertheless, carry on. And weather is currently looking quite pleasant, but there are several rain clouds in the sky, so we're just going to keep going and see how we feel. On the road again. Me and Emily were just discussing that this path, for the most part of the journey so far, has been really well maintained and well kept. Oh, water off the trees. And it's been half decently signposted as well. We haven't really had to use the map that much. So it's been quite a pleasant walk in terms of finding your way and directions and so on and so forth. You'll also notice I'm not carrying the Hyperlite pack on this trip. I've got the old Lightwave rucksack on at 1.6 kilograms, I think it is. That's because Emily is carrying the Hyperlite one because I wanted to try and lighten her load as much as possible. So she's sitting with a base weight of about, not a base weight, she's sitting at an overall weight of about 10.5 kilos and I've got about 14. So try to take some of the weight off her. How are you finding the pack?
Yeah, it's nice.
You're comfortable?
Yeah.
So she's alright. Some sailing boats on the lake at the minute, which is quite nice. You probably can't see them, but small sailing boats. I don't know if any of you remember the floodings in the Lake District, but that's that shop over there, the outdoor shop. Absolutely flooded out. So they're doing all the repairs at the moment. Here's another picture. Pretty interesting stuff. So we've just been to the tourist information centre because we want to try and avoid getting bitten alive like we did last night, because we didn't enjoy all the midges. It didn't make camp enjoyable. So we've been to the tourist information centre and it looks like there's a campsite, roughly where we were planning on camping anyway, and it's a farming campsite, so it shouldn't be too expensive. So we're going to head there and just see. If not, we can always do the wild camping. We'll see how it goes. I saw the sign. Oh, I actually saw the sign this time, not you. Right, we're back on the Old Waterway. I think. Heading to Howtown. Look at that little cute house. We're the other side of the lake now. What's that town, Emily? I can't remember.
Glenriddig.
Glenriddig. So we've passed through there this morning. That's where we stopped at the information centre to find out about the campsite.
And Patterdale behind us, isn't it?
Yeah, just passed through Patterdale. And the weather is holding out. Quite nice today, it's forecast some seriously heavy showers today, so touch wood. It's looking quite nice.
Still flying.
He says. So, where you see that little white blob there, that's where we were camping last night. We've only been walking for about an hour, 2 hours, and we've got round the whole lake, and we're coming back round now, so we're pretty much level. And that's that island, sorry, I'm trying to walk and film. That's that island there that we were talking about last night. Where I was saying canoes, and there's some canoes out there actually. It's gorgeous scenery, absolutely gorgeous. Oh, there's quite a few people on the trail there, bub. That's a good trail. I really like a it's not well maintained, it's just a nice, good trail to walk on. You're not like aimlessly trying to find paths. You're just good. Now the map reading has been minimal, which is quite nice and relaxing for a change. Okay, so we're doing a bit of a lunch stop, and we've come to a little cafe. It's somewhere on the route. We didn't know it was going to happen until some random walker told us it was here. So we've paid for some coffees, and got the classic cheese string and pepperoni. It always looks more appetizing than mine. Got a lunch with a view, very nice. Probably can't see it there because it's quite zoomed out. I can't zoom in anymore, but that's a red deer. I think it's definitely a doe. But apparently it's one of the few places in England that actually have red deer, so that's pretty cool. I think we're a little bit misted up here, hang on. So we had a nice pleasant visit at that cafe. That is on the north side of the Old Water Lake. We're really overexposed, aren't we? What's going on here? Sort this a bit, Brian. Oh my god. There you go. As I say, what a nice visit to the cafe, and now we've got about 5.5 kilometres left till we get to our campsite. And the sun's going, that's all. So we're, what time is it? 2 o'clock. So we've got 4 hours to do 5.5 kilometres.
Well, we
easy thing. Yeah, yeah, we did it. We can do that, no problem.
No problem, man. Up.
I'm gonna have a yeah. Feel good now.
What you doing, y'all? Well, Emily's made the decision that she's got hot feet. Is that nice? Emily's got a brusher boots wearing, and I'm rocking the old Carrymore trainers. still holding out quite well. We also want to get a bit battered now because they've done a couple of 100 miles, so, and they're only cheap, but you're going for a swim, you're going pretty deep there.
I reckon I could swim in it.
I'd love to go for a swim. If we thought about it, we could have brought our swimming stuff. Okay, so my trail mix of choice for this weekend has been chocolate raisins, honey dried cashew nuts, and Emily introduced me to yogurt covered raisins as well. So that's my trail mix. Emily, what have you got?
The same, but Brazil nuts instead of honey roasted nuts.
Brazil nuts. I think mine's better.
I think mine's better.
I'll fight you. So it's been pretty sherry today. The raincoats have been on and off.
It's
humid, it's about 85% humidity. But we're just taking a moment to appreciate the view because it's easy to get carried away and forget about looking up. And we're currently, chasing a group of lads who look like, eh? Oh yeah, I saw them earlier. And we're currently chasing a group of lads who look like they've had a rough night. I'll show you if I can. Okay. So we found the young lads. I didn't get a chance to video them because they asked for a helping hand with the map. So we've pointed them in the right direction and they're heading up the fell now. So we've said our goodbyes. Emily now needs the walking poles. Emily's using the Craghopper walking poles because she's got some blisters, haven't you?
Yeah.
I think it's because she's got her winter boots on. And her feet have got quite sweaty, etc. And obviously got wet and developed blisters. So there's a gate on a stile. This is, I suppose, a sheep could maybe get through there. So. So she's looking at getting herself some either trainers or some lighter weight hiking boots for the summer, aren't you? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's our campsite, and I do believe that is the building possibly, because it's a small farm with a campsite attached. So it's just over here. Let's go. We've made a good time as well. It's not even 5:30 yet, so we have plenty of time to relax after our chaotic night last night. We've been eaten alive.
And chaotic morning.
And chaotic. Yeah.
Hello. I'm not getting alive again.
Okay, so we finally got to our campsite and it is glorious. Sun is shining, nice empty flat field. We've got a nice table here that we're gonna chill out on for the evening, and we're just gonna relax now for the next, we're gonna relax for the next 5 or 7 hours. Go down to the water, see what we can see down there. See if we can dip our feet maybe. So here's all the caravans and our random ass setup. Just got the top. Same configuration as last night with the walking poles, but it's just quite funny in comparison to everyone's tents and caravans. But yeah, it's really nice and sweet here. Plenty of time to relax. Okay folks, so for those of you who have stayed with the video this long, I'm now going to show you the route that we have done over the past 2 days, and that will have been 3 days once we've finished. So here we go. Oh god. So here's the map.
Hold it down.
No, please. So this is all water lake. We started up here at Pooley Bridge. to park the car there, and we walk the north side of the lake first. The north side of the lake is the least public area that we've found so far. There's several areas of interest along the way, one being the Air Force. There's some waterfalls. We didn't get to see those because we were short for time, but apparently they're meant to be good. Next up, we camped somewhere in this region. I'm not going to specify just for the sake of it, but I'm sure you can find your own campsites elsewhere. There's plenty, all these dots are campsites and stuff, so there's plenty of campsites if you want to camp it, but we had a cheeky wild camp in this region. And then this morning we came round Glen Ridding.
Through Pattersdale,
all around here, and we are currently camping at this campsite, which is a good campsite actually, called Cross Dormant. That's where we're camping at the minute. In the morning, we've got a short skip and a hop, a couple of kilometres, back into Pooley Bridge, and to the car.
Is it yours?
Yeah.
You know it mine.
No, I'm sure looking.
I wondered if it was done now.
Right, so for tonight's meal, I've got beef, pork, and what is it there? chickpea noodles. What have you got?
I have got pasta carbonara.
Smell mine, just because you don't trust my dehydrated meals.
Can I try it?
Yeah, let me try it first, make sure it's right. Still needs a bit more rehydrating, some crunchy bits in there, but it's good shit.
It's good shit. Come on.
Okay. Oh, look at that. Who needs a tripod when you've got a sock? Oh, the sun's gone behind the cloud, that's a bit nice. That sun's pretty intense.
Are we coming back out to the sunset?
Yeah, well, the wind, the clouds are moving quite quickly.
I can tell, I set two socks. It's definitely a win.
Oh god. Okay, oh god, I had to work. Okay, so that's pretty much the end of our trip, really. There's only a trip back to the car to do tomorrow, which I'll show on the video, but just kind of wanted to wrap it up here. So, we've done basically 20 miles around the lake. It was a hit and miss with the weather, but for the most part we've had pretty decent weather. We've been, can't really complain really, it's been like a typical British weekend, hasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Emily's got some blisters, but it's her first kind of long distance hike, like over a day's hike, so and we also think her boots might be slightly too small, so we're going to look into that. And other than that, there's a few things that we also think we could do with getting, because we're still kind of progressing with our kit in terms of like couple, like all my kit is kind of just for me at the minute, so there's a few things we think we could get that could benefit us as a pair. For example, a tent, because that thing, although it's good, it ain't really cutting it, especially last night with the midges. Is there anything else we could say we could do with?
I need a chair.
Emma wants a chair because I buy the chair and she gets to sit in it. Anything else? I can't remember. We recently got the new pot, that's for the both of us. Overall, it's been a very successful trip, and it was, I don't know if I mentioned this, but it was all Emily's idea. She found the trip, she decided she wanted to do it, so we just came and did it. And I'm really pleased with the path as well. The walk is really well maintained, pretty well signposted.
The start of it wasn't the best, the best when it comes to being signposted, but the rest was absolutely fantastic. Didn't really have to use the map, so it was nice and relaxed. No complaints from me. So yeah, if you do want to check that out, it's the Alls Waterway. And yeah, just hit it up. There's plenty of campsites to go on, and they're not too expensive. Or you can try and get the wild camps in there. But it's not the easiest wild camp, I'll be honest, because it is quite a popular route and quite a popular area, but it is possible. But yeah, the campsite, it's quite nice to just go on a campsite, to be honest. It's nice knowing that you're going to have somewhere to camp. You haven't got to worry about trying to find somewhere, and you've just got the facilities, you can get your water from the tap and stuff, and it's not crazy money. So yeah, we're just going to sit here and watch the sun go down, and then we're going to go to bed, and we'll be at the car in no time. Right then, folks, we are leaving. What's the campsite called? I can never remember the names of anything.
No, it's Norton.
There's a sign called it anyway. It's a very good campsite, beautifully placed in front of the river. And we've got the last couple of kilometres to go until we hit the car. I'm gonna have a yeah. On the road again. Feel good now. Okay, folks, so we are almost back now. And that unfortunately brings us to the end of our trip. It's been a good one. Emily's really enjoyed herself, haven't you?
Yeah.
And she's literally just asked me what's the next trip we're doing. And she's thinking Derwent Water. So I have no doubt she'll get that planned as soon as she gets back. And we're ending on a very pleasant day. So yeah. I hope you enjoyed the video. And until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll see you again very, very soon.